Hi everybody, my name is John Andrews. I'm the Social and Digital Media Manager for Redport Information Assurance. And today's screencast is going to be on the difference between malware, spyware, and adware. So with that being said, let's get started. The contents on what we are going to be covering today, first is about and why I'm going to be talking about the topic we are discussing today. Before leading into the first bullet, which is malware, second being spyware, third being adware. So you've probably been wondering, or you know, if you're fairly new to using a computer, people often tend to be confused or not even know at all the difference between malware, spyware, and adware, whether it's good or bad, and the meaning and purpose of each one. Instances that this may show up vary, but normally each word is noticed when simply browsing the internet. So what do these words actually mean? Malware is a shortened term meaning malicious software, basically any sorts of software that may harm, intrude, or gain sensitive forms of information from the user of a private computer. If or when your computer encounters a malware infection, so to speak, it could disrupt your computer's operation or could ultimately shut down everything and crash. Malware essentially is a broad spectrum which houses infections that your computer's antivirus, firewall, or anti-malware software may detect, such as computer viruses, worms, Trojan horses, spyware, adware, and other infectious programs. So with that being said, now we move on to spyware, and what is the difference? Well, spyware, yes, is a type of malware, but spyware does just that, spies on the user through a downloaded software or program that the user personally puts on their computer. In layman terms, think about downloading some sort of software for free off of the internet. Now imagine yourself being a small component within that program that gains sensitive information from the user. Whether that means the web pages that you browse, credit card numbers you enter for online purchases, or simply every keystroke you make on your keyboard. For the more advanced tech geeks out there, ones who illegally pirate programs for free off the internet, have more vulnerability in gaining some sort of spyware from the programs downloaded. This may come from script codes, active content in the program, or something else of that matter, but typically, what will happen when your computer recognizes a spyware detection is that your computer's firewall or antivirus program, which I will make a different video on later, will quarantine or completely get rid of the risk. The majority of users who operate a PC are ones who generally have this program, especially novice computer users who buy their private computers for the first time. As the years progress, the prices of computers, especially Windows PCs, decrease. I see a lot of Dell computer purchases happen. Usually with each purchase of a new computer, Dell gives you some sort of trial, typically lasting for about 90 days or so. Sure, users will take this instant perk, but once the trial runs out, the virus definitions are updated, and sooner than you realize, you don't have an antivirus program running on your computer, making your computer more susceptible to intrusion. But enough with spyware and on adware, which isn't as complex or complicated as spyware for that matter. Adware you could commonly associate with to pop-ups. You could categorize pop-ups in this sense as adware solely because of this. When you click on ads, somewhere within that embedded file or source code may be some sort of spyware. It may not be a harmful form of spyware, but what adware commonly is known for is tracking what kind of web pages you access while you're on your internet browser. Once there's a time that your browser, depending on which one you're using, which I will do another video on later, when your browser starts going haywire with pop-ups and you can't stop it, that's mainly because you've been getting a little trigger happy with the mouse clicks on other websites which are causing these pop-ups to come up because they assume, because of the past web pages you viewed, that you'll keep clicking and clicking and clicking. So with that being said, to wrap up, malware, just associated with malicious software. You know, it's bad software. It's something that you don't want on your computer, and that's just the general term and what it means. Spyware is a little bit more specific. It's a type of malware, and it's a software that spies, so to speak, on a certain aspect of your computer, which is potentially harmful. And the last one we covered, which was Adware, is acquired through access of ads on a website, commonly known as pop-ups. And a lot of people are generally, I would say, exposed to that type of malware versus others. So that is my little review, just a small quick review on what malware, spyware, and adware are. And just for those of you who are really not as knowledgeable in the technological field, that's just a little review on what malware, spyware, and adware are and the difference between each. So with that being said, check out our website at www.redport-ia.com, which offers quality information assurance and computer security. And also check out our Facebook page at facebook.com/redport, and also follow us on Twitter at redport_ia. Thank you. I'm John Andrews, and everybody have a nice day.